way, hit the open road this summer, smart way to road trip, and seek new adventures. Go a little farther this summer in a new Chevy. Find new get up and go, find new roads. Enjoy the open road and make no more payments for the rest of summer fall 2022, except for $1,500 plus. Get 2.49% financing and refinance with GM Financial. Find new roads at Chevrolet Chevy.
I'm just so glad there was somebody there because she really needed it.
That's so good.
the road this summer. A smart way to road trip and seek new adventures. Go a little further this summer in a new Chevy. Find new get up and go and find new roads. Now in the open road and make one of the payments for the rest of summer of fall 2022, so we're out of 1500 pickups. Plus, get 2.49% financing and finance with GM Financial.
The PK Fargo Drilling was going to satisfy your cravings. It was safe with Southwest Baby Walker Jr.
And do your research, but I say all the time.
Southwest Baby Walker Jr. Only a hurricane.
For those who love peanut butter.
Yeah, but they can't get it because if you're. Right! If you're.
Married to peanut butter, I now pronounce you.
I'm just gonna throw that out there because everybody knows.
The ultimate. It's here.
And you're a professional. You've gone through, okay, $8,000 to $10,000, perfecting your technique or whatever. And you're at home. You're using Sally Hansen, and then you're trying to get wind of, oh, she uses Sally Hansen. So why did it sell? What did I give her $60 for? To use a $10, $9 wax on me. I'm not coming back to you. I'm gonna go to Sally. I'm gonna buy Sally Hansen wax. Especially you have clients that are just, you know, they may just get their underarm. Everybody's not gonna get a Brazilian, everybody's not gonna get a full leg. Some people may come just because they want to get their forearm and their underarm. That's an easy thing to do though, right? You can literally stand in the mirror with your Sally Hansen on your roller and do it. So I always tell you, hey, good morning guys. I know I already started talking about being a professional professional product. But one of the entire points, and I've said this several times as well, about being a professional, is that you want to be exclusive. You want to be exclusive. I personally, as an esthetician, because I know how I like them done, because I do stuff, I don't even do my own wax. There. I have somebody that I go to. I don't do my own wax. I have somebody that I go to. Because I want the experience too. I want to lay down and, you know. But if I go to someone and I'm walking in and I see that she's using, what is something for kids? I'll make for that. Ashley Pink's product, right? And I see that that's what she's using and she's doing my face and she's doing Ashley Pink product. But I go in the local beauty supply.
Wesley.
you'll see a huge difference.
What was the middle name?
Dean.
You know what was really fucking crazy?
What?
Because if they were that.
There's a song on the radio right now. The artist's name, yeah, and guess what it is?
Wesley Dean?
Yes.
That's weird.
I know. He's a new artist.
Their product, Cosmopolitan,
huh. Only
by,
yeah,
hair.
Really weird. I'm like, what?
That is really weird.
I had to like call you like as soon as it hurt.
That is really weird.
I will look you up here so you can continue lecture.
All right, I love you.
I love you too.
Bye, babe.
Bye, Heather. So it is exclusive to an extent. A lot of people don't know that. But you can't, no, you cannot go buy it at Target, Walmart, or Farmhouse Fresh. Yeah, you have to go on their line. And the only way I knew about it is because the private owned farm that I worked at, that is what it's owned. And that's the only way I ever knew about it. If I never knew about it because of the perk, I probably would have. Professional vendors are there. Farmhouse Fresh is there. They are there. They are there. They are representing. They are. I mean, it's a huge brand. It's a huge organic brand. I love it because I get to say, it's on a, yes, it's on a farm. If everything is natural, it's made out of, ma'am. Products that I use are farmhouse friends because they're organic. So like when I come, when I get
Sunday. I'm actually out there to get some more. It smells like hot cocoa. Just like hot cocoa. It's almost like a chocolate souffle. And I use the mask on that area for the mask. And then just imagine hot cocoa and the steam hitting. My whole smells like chocolate. And they love that because it gives them an experience. You're laying there and you're, you know, steaming, got spa music going on, and now the room smells like chocolate. And you want to think about that. Think about giving an experience with the products that you use. And a lot of them is because Farmhouse Fresh, you can wholesale it. If you have someone that has that sensitive skin or only want to use organic products, you can have a wholesale account. Buy the product in bulk. And then you sell them. It's a product that now you sell in series in your box. So that's the good thing about having professional products, because you can get those wholesale accounts. And normally when you have a wholesale account, like I'll say CPA, my wholesale account CPA as a professional, I get everything at 50% off. Everything. All of my watches, all of my clothing, all of my masks, everything is 50% off. So specifically, my clients are buying through me. Let me start talking to me. Come on. Oh, this is Melissa. Hold on, Melissa. In reference to our conversation the other day, I spoke to my mom, and she said the Canadian brand, that word, lukewarm wax is the only one she has found on the market that comes close to the wax she uses. They have hard wax too, but she uses soft. Oh, y'all write that down. So you remember Melissa, the other Melissa, who was telling us that her mom has been over at Institution for over 20-something years, and she worked for that one lady that had the wax that she formulated, and she passed away, and there's only like 3 people in the world. And you spell it E-P-I-L-L-Y-S-S, and then it says lukewarm wax. So she said that this is the only wax that she has found on the market that is close to the wax that was manufactured by the owner of the purchase store.
And it's pretty cool.
Thank you so much.
And they actually have training, and they have tons of other products you can look at.
Really? And the training is free, right?
I'm not sure. I'm looking at it right now to see. They have videos. They even do sugaring. They have 2 different ones, but the Evolus ones that they do, it's by this guy from Paris, but it's out of Canada. She said sometimes it can be a little difficult to find or more expensive because they're low or whatever, or just due to shipping, but she said that's the closest one, and their soft wax is really good.
So now we're all gonna have to go and try this. So that means it's probably really melt evenly, so the heat is distributed real even. Which is a good thing. But if you've always used or waxed him, then that's probably why. All right, so this is all good conversation. We haven't dived into the chapter because we don't have a lot to do today. But this is all good conversation about, you know, being able to pick your wax and what type of product it is that you want to use. So just be mindful of the products that you want to use. You want to make sure that your clients feel exclusive. And that it justifies your price as well. You have to feel like you're over. Even $4 can wax from Sally's and charging $80 for. So you want to, you know, still be ethical, but make sure that you are using a good product as well. Once you get a pro wax, right? Once you get a pro wax and you use that, you will completely sell it. Like even Melissa's already saying now, from what the wax they were using versus the wax that she has at home, that she can tell the difference.
Mm-hmm.
because you never use anything. But once you start, like I said, I went through all kinds. I use mermaid wax. It's a wax that everybody uses. Everybody likes the little color. It's a hot right. So that's what I say when people on TikTok or they're on, you know, all these. And you gotta remember, some of the people that have a high content of population, they're getting paid to do that. So it's not going to be that fun. Because they have a huge following, people will say, I will give you a mere supply of wax if you, you know, whatever. They're like, okay, yeah, sure. And I used it, and I was like, oh, I want to try it. It was so green. It's all these colors. And I was so ready to finish what I had gotten because I was just like, sure. I didn't like it. I didn't like the way it, I didn't like the way it laid. And then it just, it didn't, just, I'm a cosmetologist. It was very good. Tamara, I think that they have a group messaging too. So you might want to find that out from somebody because I think they have a group messaging.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, if anybody in the class will post the number for that or link, like just coming in and not having a lot of the background, it'd be nice to bounce just a few questions off of them when I do homework.
Perfect. Someone, if you guys can maybe post your group messaging for Tamara, that would be great. Let's just get on into this. As I stated for the laters that came in, we do have a writing class today at 1. Also, book, I don't know if I ever say it right, book will be here today as well. So they'll have a class for you guys to attend as well. And I know you're probably like, who's that? What is that? That is the site that they use here at the school. A lot of institutions use it, not just the school. There's a lot of people that use it. It's a personal preference, but to book their clients. So just how their pocket seats, just how their acuity, just how their style seats, just like their stripe, their square. There's so many different booking sites. The school is particularly used for that company, and they do come in every, you know, once a month or every few times, every so often in a month, to go over it with you guys, explain to you how it works, how you can make money off of it, and when you, you know, graduate and become a pro, how you can actually get that account set up. So they're going to be here as well today. Yeah. Like the credit card reader, non-credit card reader, all that kind of stuff. So you guys do have some stuff to do today. All right, so let's just call me in now that we have everybody here. We are going to start at slide 46. We are on page 478. Page 478. And it is going to be completing the client consultation form. Facial. It is necessary to do a client consultation form for a waxer. Melissa, why would you want to do a client consultation form before waxing? You want to find out contraindications, and by having a consultation is how you're going to find out if they have those contraindications. What else? Mm-hmm. what I'm looking for. When was the last time they waxed? Because before they, say for instance, they come in for a Brazilian, and the last time they had a wax was 2 weeks ago, right? But they're fully closed at this point, so you don't know. But the last time they had a wax was 2 weeks ago, or shave, or anything, any type of hair. But maybe they weren't happy with them. Maybe they felt like they left too much hair behind. Or they feel like, oh, I don't like double, it's grown back so fast. But you're talking to them and they're like, yeah, well, that, we did the hair removal 2 weeks ago, but you left patches. And you're like, well, what do you mean some patches? Well, I mean, I feel like they're still double and fuzzy. That's something you can't, like, you're gonna have to grow in more. So before you let her get all the way undressed, all the way on the table, you have 2 weeks ago, I'm sorry, unfortunately, you need to have at least 4 to 6 weeks of growth. No, I promise you, it's a lot. Okay, and then at that time, you can say, well, you know what, I can take a look. Maybe they have, like, wolf genes, I don't know. Maybe it is a lot. And you're like, oh, that's 2 weeks of growth? Okay, well, that's enough. And then you wax them. But then they get on there and it's really like, you know, and you're like, bam, no, you can't. So that's why you definitely want to make sure that you do consultation. You want to make sure that you're signing consent as well. You will have parents that bring in children under the age of 18. I tell everybody all the time, my youngest is 12. And she gets a deep bikini. Not a full Brazilian, but she gets a deep bikini because she is a swimmer. She swims professionally. So as she started, you know, going to puberty and having hair, her mom was like, she cannot be looking like that. You know, with the going down the leg and they have on the high cut swimsuits. And so her mom gets Brazilian and she was like, what can we do? I don't want it all gone because she's 12, but I don't want her to shave because I know what that's like, you know, being a shaver, but what can we do? And so we decided to do a deep bikini. So she has a small to medium triangle, I guess you could say, is that we do. But and she's been coming down for probably a year. I think I can probably hurt her now. But I did have to get a signed consent from her mom to do it and make sure her mom has been in the room. Now, 13, she's been coming to me for over a year. She's like, I really don't know. And so her mom will go and, you know, maybe run an errand or whatever. And most of the time she just say, like, whatever. Because it's literally, it's that case. I mean, it's 3 or 4 scripts and she's done. But making sure that you guys are definitely getting those signed consent. And of course, you get it that one time and then you won't have to worry about it. The service will be successful and beneficial. The hair wax to be 1/4 of an inch long, if virgin hair or fine regrowth. Hair should be 1/2 inch long, approximately 10 to 14 days growth post shaving. So it's saying on here 10 to 14 days. That's what? 2 weeks. 9 times out of 10, there's never going to be a 2 week that's that long to where you can. Unless you are doing what? Sugaring. Because sugaring will wrap around the hair. Remember we talked about it yesterday? You can actually get sugar a lot quicker than, oh, you weren't here yesterday. That's what happened. But it's possible to find this ingrown hair 4 days prior to allowing it. Recommended to use a loofah or exfoliating body scrub prior, but not day of service. And that is very important. We'll have a lot of people because they haven't exfoliated as they should have prior to coming. We'll try to do a mask.
should be waxing a week prior, days prior. So you will have people that will try to exfoliate you before they come in. So be mindful of that and make sure that you're asking them. So contraindications can be on the legs, varicose veins, signs with skin disorder, epilepsy, diabetes, other contraindicated medical conditions can obviously stop them from getting a wax. Signs who have listed contraindications below need a physician's approval, such as recent treatments or product uses of medical medication, scar tissue, mold. So mold in certain areas, you might have to wax around because you don't want to rip it off. Skin tags, warts, skin disorders, skin, fragile skin. Other things to consider, avoid inside of nose, ears, eyelids, around the areola, and nipples. And you can wax the nose. You can wax the nose and you can wax the ears. I would avoid waxing the eyelids. I never had anybody. You can rent around it, but I've never had a woman. But I have, because I've done the full body, like the chest on men. Soft or hard. Pregnant women in the last trimester, if they have to lie flat for more than 20 minutes. You did it the day before? Really? You just laid, but what, you got a Brazilian wax? Oh, but your husband did. Oh, okay. Did it take long? It didn't take a long time for her to eat. Pregnant women tend to get real hot quickly, so you gotta do it fast and you have to continue to dry out that moisture. Adding the point, but I've had some pregnant ladies, not anybody that was like that, but I get pregnant ladies because they want to be clean down there before they go into labor. Okay, make sure you're checking for product allergy. Well, and they have varicose veins, their skin can probably be really thin too, like on the legs. And so you just want to be varicose vein hurt. Oh, you know what they do? That's why they have to wear compression socks. I had a friend that actually was getting, well, I don't know if he's done it already or done, but you can do something surgically or like laser, something with laser to get them removed or something like that. Really? So, to think about that, waxing legs and have some varicose veins, yeah, probably hurt. Consideration needs of the transgender client. Okay? So male to female gender reassignment is of professional interest to estheticians as a professional services and hair removal, and it is often called for. Stages for a patient to go through to complete gender reassignment from male to female. So you want to make sure that you are being emotionally intact when you are dealing with a transgender. So say for instance you have someone that is going from male to female. Okay? So they may physically look like a female. They may have taken hormones now, their voice is soft, their hair is long, they may have breasts, but they may still have male genitals. So they get on the table and you think you're doing sterile, right? And it's really
that you're not offended or offensive. Here's some glass. You're not offensive, but you can feel like it. Go with it. Right, and they won't. Most of them won't say. It's all late. So she had went to that. Get it? Yeah, but did it look like? That's what we're asking. But you have to be mindful of that too, because I feel like that's a sticky situation, because everybody doesn't wax the men, right? If you've never waxed a man before and you have someone that comes and they're transgender, you're thinking you're getting ready to do some labia pulls and, you know, get them on out of the door. I wax them. I can tell you it is completely I'm not comfortable with waxing for sake, because I don't want to hurt. I've never waxed it. Because you're not trained in that. You know what I'm saying? You're not trained in that. That's if I could be only trained to go to wax it, then you had a lady. And you've never done a lady before. You've never done a Brazilian wax. So, in this industry, you can absolutely come across it. Patients may be advised to dress as women, and they may seek services to feel more feminine in women's clothing. They do take hormone replacements, which is HRT, hormone replacement therapy. Patients often undergo laser treatments and electrolysis to the face and other body areas. So you can have the male to female gender transition come in and absolutely look just like a woman until they, you know, take off their body. Okay, items needed in a wax. So, please, what is one item that you would need in a wax? Wax. Baby mama, what is one item? I'm thinking there is a list. Is there a list on what page? 483. Okay. Give me another item that is needed in the wax. A stool. Okay. Laura, item needed in a wax room. Oh, with two of them. It's two of them. You're masters. I don't call you Laura. Okay, what did you say? Wax room. Melissa online. You're applying soft or hard. You're going to use an applicator to apply it. It's the only difference is when you take it off.
waxing strip?
Yes, you're gonna need some type of waxing strip. What are the two types of waxing strips?
Oh goodness.
Yeah, making sure. You talked about it yesterday. You might have to go back a little bit. I want her to
hold the hair yesterday.
Oh, so that means you gotta do a little bit more digging.
I do.
That is on page 482. Phone a friend. Ask one of your fellow online students to help you out. We're a team. Someone that was online yesterday, help out Tamara.
One of them is Leslie.
Correct. And there's one other.
The Pellet or Pellon, I don't know that's name.
Correct. So remember that, Tamara. There's two types of waxing strips that you can use. Tell her one more time.
Muslin and Pellon.
Muslin and Pellon.
Okay.
I'm not the best at saying them right either, but that's it. All right.
And is the second one the smooth paper? When you say it with the muslin, so the second one's that smooth paper?
It's the one that's thicker, yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you. Is there anything else that we need in the wax room? I think we're forgetting some stuff. Gloves. Hand sanitizer. Paper roll for the bed. Our pre-clean before you wax them. Yeah, your scarf or your powder to dry up the moisture. Master said tweezers or little scissors that you might need to cut. If you're doing brows or spoolie, what are you going to use after you, your post-cream or your post-oil after you wax them? For aloe vera, some people may have, as we said, antihistamine reaction. So you want something to kind of soothe the skin, so it may be an aloe vera. Perfect. So wax equipment. Your furniture should be designed so that both estheticians and your clients are comfortable. Furniture in a wax room includes, but are not limited to, adjustable waxing tables, stools or chairs that you are going to sit in. I wax standing up, pretty much all body parts, besides face and eyebrows. Multi-tiered rolling cart. Just like you have your lash cart, you may have a multi-tiered rolling cart for your wax supplies. Assortment of different containers and applicators that may hold your cotton and your gauze, your tweezers, and things of that matter. Your waste container. Oh, we didn't say that. Definitely have your waste container. Covered waste container at that. Your disinfectant that you are going to store your tools in after you have a wax. An assortment of towels and linens. If you are a person like me, everybody gets a what after I wax. I know you know this. Everybody gets a hot towel free. That's why everybody loves to get a wax box. Because I create experience. All of my waxes are different. Everybody gets the hot towel treatment after a wax. Let me be clear. Everybody gets hot towel treatment after a refill wax. So not after coming to get your arm. No. But everybody gets a what? Massage after a wax with me. So even if I do your arm, get about 36 massage. If I do legs, get 36 massage. But everybody does get a hot towel after every refill. So when I come in, I go through a lot of towels in the day. But it's really not a service that I don't use a hot towel. Get your facial, get a hot towel. You get a Brazilian, get a hot towel. Those are my most useful services, facials and Brazilian. So making sure that your hot towel warmer is on and that you have plenty of clean towels. Your essentials in the wax treatment room. Your heater containing hard and or soft wax, depending if you are going to use both. Some want to just soft wax, as we talked about. Some just want to use hard wax, as we talked about. Again, personal, professional, preference. Your tweezers, slanted and pointed, made of surgical steel. Scissors for trimming eyebrows. Scissors for cutting wax strips. Metal spatulas. Sufficient number to ensure double dipping is not necessary. Now, I don't use metal spatulas. I don't know why you would use a metal spatula. Maybe that's what they're using to just stir in the very beginning, making sure that it is evenly distributed heat wise. But we are using disposable lozenger sticks. Speaking of single use or disposable items, bikini bottoms. As I showed in the Juicy Wax video yesterday, when someone comes in and she's getting a bikini wax so that it is not getting on her own underwear,